Today's Christie novel brings us back to Paris. Death in the Clouds is an interesting novel for Christie because it takes something very modern and something very ancient and kind of combines it. The murder on this in this story takes place on an airline, and air travel was still relatively new for most people, kind of a novelty for some people. And yet the murder weapon that's used on this plane, or the supposed murder weapon, is a small blowpipe from a native tribe, and indeed a small dart that has been, the tip of which has been poisoned with the poison of some sort of snake indigenous to South America, has been found on this, on the plane next to the dead woman. The blowpipe itself is found under Poirot's seat, or in the cushion of his seat, throwing immediate suspicion on him. So Poirot is really trying to clear his name. And this story, it's very interesting as far as location as well, because it begins in Paris. It's a flight from Paris to Croydon in England. The minute they get back, they get to England, they discover this woman who's sitting in the rear part of the plane is dead. They thought she was asleep. They find a small puncture in her neck, and some of the clues include this small poison dart as well as a dead wasp and a long cigarette holder. One of the interesting things about this is that it's sort of like a locked room mystery because almost anyone in this small cabin of this plane would have seen someone take out a blowpipe and shoot a dart at someone. It was very difficult. This would be a very difficult crime to commit. So, and in that way, it's like a locked room mystery. All of the people are basically prisoners of this airline cabin. So we go back and forth. After they arrive in England, Poirot goes back to Paris and works with Fournier, who is a police officer or a police detective in Paris. Then he goes back to England and he does some investigating with the help of a young woman named Jane Grey, which may or may not be a direct reference to Lady Jane Grey, who was a queen for 14 days or something like that before she was beheaded. But this Jane Grey is a much more hopeful character, and she becomes kind of Poirot's personal secretary for this. She fills the Hastings role, but again, much more intelligently, in the same way that Dr. Shepherd fills the role much more intelligently in the murder of Roger Ackroyd, and some of these other characters that fill in the Hastings role. So we go back and forth between Paris and London, but most of the action does take place in London, in and around London. And this is a very interesting novel, and I think it's one where Christie's really coming into her own. We see the presentation of the facts very clearly laid out. This is not the novel of a rookie or a newbie. She's very confident in the way that she handles this. And then by the end, we have what's going to be somewhat of a trademark that was probably established in a novel like Murder on the Orient Express, where the bulk of the novel is the investigation, and the final chapter or two is the summing up. And in this one, it's very typical of what you would see what you'll see in later Christie novels, and what you'll see in adaptations of all different kinds of mysteries, where all of the suspects are gathered together, and Poirot gives his summation of the case, and of course he leaves it till just the very last minute before revealing who the murderer is. The solution to this is in some ways very simple, but in other ways very complex. Maybe it's because of the simplicity that it is so difficult to figure out. Christie is just amazing at taking seemingly normal events and creating drama around them, or obscuring very obvious facts, and then when you go back and read them, you think, oh, well, I should have guessed this from the beginning. So for this one, for Death in the Clouds, I would give it a 4.5 out of 5. It's not up there with her best, but it is among some of her better novels. So next time I'll be reviewing The ABC Murders.